Sri T.R. Baluji.
Honorable Speaker, sir, in the midst of cyclone, tempest and tsunami, the Honorable Speaker has permitted me to speak in Parliament about the law and order situation of Delhi. See, the law and order situation of Delhi is not only being discussed in the Temple of Democracy, Indian Parliament, sir, but also it is being discussed in UK Parliament, Indonesia, Iran. This is my mic. The law and order situation of Delhi is being discussed not only in Indian Parliament, sir, but also it is being discussed in United Kingdom, the Parliament of United Kingdom, Indonesia, Iran, Turkey, and Malaysia, showing concern about not only on CA, but also law and order situation of the Delhi. Sir, paradoxical situation prevails in Delhi, in a place Shaheen Bagh. Shaheen Bagh is observing Dharna for the 88th day today. Today is the 88th day without any commotion, without any problem, without any making any land and situation for people around. Silently, peacefully it is going on. The Dharna is going on. Because the minority, they are conducting on their own. The Dharna is going on. Whereas, in other place, in the southeast Delhi, Jafarabad, what has happened, sir? 50, northeast Delhi, more than 53 people have killed. 500 people have been injured and they are hospitalized. What went wrong, sir? Because in Shaheen Bagh, only anti-CAA protesters were participating in Dharna. Here, not only in anti-CAA, but also pro-CAA people belonging to the ruling party, that is BJP. That is the problem. So when they protest and come for confrontation, the law and order situation worsens. It costed 53 lives. More than 500 people are still in hospital. These are the real outcomes, sir. Sir, my dear sir, Delhi police is known for their professional efficiency and competency to control any sorts of riots, such riots at any point of time. They can raise to any occasion. Many officers who are in the Home Ministry are capable of handling not only the police administration, but also their own day-to-day administration. I know them personally. What is happening nowadays? Home Minister is there, a mighty Home Minister, to whom we believe that law and order of this country will be kept up properly. But nowadays, what is happening? Why all went wrong? Where are we going? All other countries, countries like Indonesia, Iran, Turkey and UK are just making fun of us. Is it proper to discuss about our democracy in other countries? Sir, my dear sir, that is why the police inaction is not attributed to the inaction of the police. It has been advised by the administration. This police, who has got the capacity to do any situation to make law and order proper, they have not come to the rescue to see that Delhi peace should prevail. Then what has happened in the first incident on 15-12? On 15-12, 2019. It has happened in JNU, in Jamia Millia University. Jamia Millia University Vice Chancellor didn't call this police. Only the police went inside. Not only went inside the campus, they went into the bathroom, they went into the library, they went into the hostels. They chased the students up to that level. Brutally injured people, students, have been hospitalized. There was no action, no FIR, nothing. This was happened without any summons. The next incident in JNU, so holistically, ABVP is the root cause for all this happenings. ABVP workers are the root cause for all this happenings. Sir, JNU, because of ABVP, things went wrong. The police outside the compound, they were sitting like a duck. No reaction from them. Things were looting is going on, arson is going on, brutality is going on inside the university. The JNU university full of arson and loot. But at the same time, police were looking at like a duck sitting outside. They were just folded their hands. What went wrong? Why? Why they have not interfered to maintain the law and order? The third incident is most important incident. My sister was narrating the story about the good behavior of Kapil Mishra, a dropout of Aam Aadmi Party. A small timer to BJP. That particular person who spoke ill, who spoke provocative speeches, who spoke hatred speeches amongst the public. On 23rd February, he has proclaimed, as if he is the Home Minister of this country, he said, I quote, 3 days ultimatum to Delhi police, get the roads clear. Don't try to convince us. After this, we will not listen to you. Just 3 days. He wants the police. Sir, I unquote. This speech was made on 23rd February, sir. He has given 3 days ultimatum. What always happened on 24th, 25th, 26th? Things went wrong. What has happened? Looting was done. Arson was, unbridled arson was on the streets. Sir, on 53 deaths have occurred, more than 500 injured, 3 mosques have been burnt to ashes, 1 school, 122 houses have been burnt to ashes, 2 cars and 300 motorcycles have been burnt. Not only this episode, even media persons have not been left out. CNN, NDTV, Times of India, Reuters, India Today, News 18, all these persons were mercilessly attacked. Their equipments were seized, thrown into the dustbins. These have happened during the daylight of this 24th and 25th or 26th of February, sir. My dear sir, even the judiciary have not been spared. I don't want to say the name of the particular person which my friend has just now mentioned. You have judges of High Court. Judges of High Court, he just mentioned why you have not taken action. The person who made provocative speeches, not my friend who is going out. The persons, again, why you have not taken any action on the persons who have made hatred, provocative speeches? The judges have asked. So overnight, marching orders have passed. Marching orders to strip the judges to somewhere else. Is it proper? Sir, judiciary was on attack. media person were on attack, minorities were on attack. Is it proper on the part of the government which has been elected by more than 300 members of parliament? My dear sir, what was the causes? Basic causes. What was the basic causes? CAA, NPR, NRC. Many people, just now, they have mentioned many times. What was the causes? Why? Why CAA? Sir, 1948, 1955, the Citizenship Act came into being. 2003, rules have been made. In 2003, there was no such parameters. Only 12 parameters were there. Now they added. My friends have added another 6 or 7. Because of the addition of the parameters, which are asking for the father's date of birth, mother's date of birth, grandmother's date of birth, license number, telephone number, and so on. These things won't be kept in confidentially. These things will be propagated. It will be in the website. Everybody, world over, everybody can see that information. There is a chance of personal liberty, sir. I want to know, sir, why these things have happened? Because of the CAA only. The root cause is CAA only. That is why people all around in Tamil Nadu, in North Chennai, for the past 40 days, agitation is going up. In my own, in my constituency, day and night, people are just on the road with children, old women and father and mother. So this is happening every day. My dear, my question to my friends, sir, only thing, sir. The very small request I am going to make, sir. What is the request? Sir, they are our brothers and sisters They are the kith and kin of this government. Why don't they go and see those people? Courtesy demands. Neither the Prime Minister nor the Home Minister, they went there with the olive branch. No, they have not extended any olive branch. They have not got the... Am I to say that they are not having the courtesy to meet those people? If there is an election, definitely these people will go. These personalities will go and beg those people, whether they are minorities or majorities. So what is happening nowadays? Sir, you want to conclude, you want me to conclude, sir, before I conclude, demands. What are other demands? Sir, there are lot of exceptions. See, more than 60 people went to the apex court. More than 12 states went against this government, passing resolution in their own state government, state assemblies. My final request is, kindly see that, as my leader, Dr. Stalin, has already requested, prevail on the Prime Minister and Home Minister to kindly ask them to go and approach those people personally, so go and meet those people so that things will get softened and explain the things what is happening. And you just get the confidence of those people. That is what he said, the first one. The second, government of India should compensate the families of deceased. Relief camp shall be provided to the riot affected people. Madrasa and schools must be restored immediately. Shop owners, businessmen shall be compensated immediately. Media persons shall be assisted properly for their loss of equipment. All the accused shall be brought to books without any loss of time. And there shall be a judiciary appointment headed by a retired Supreme Court judge. Thank you, sir.